Hello students, today in this session we are going to discuss about few more classes of the phylum Arthropoda. Yesterday we have discussed about general characteristic feature of the phylum Arthropoda and we have discussed about the one class that is the class Onychophora. Today we are going to discuss about few more classes. Okay, so let's see the next class under phylum Arthropoda, that is second class, class Archaenida. Class Archaenida. Archaenida. Okay. So, in this class, we are going to discuss few important characteristic features. Okay. So, the members of class Archaenida, okay, they have the body divided into three different segments or two different segments. That is, we'll write the characteristics of this, then we'll come to know that. In this class, the body is divided into cephalothorax and abdomen. Okay, so the body is divided into two main parts, that is cephalothorax and abdomen. Now, what is meant by cephalothorax? Cephalothorax is nothing but head plus thorax. So, head plus thoracic region is referred as the cephalothorax and it consists of the abdomen. The next, cephalothorax have four pairs of walking legs. Four pairs of walking legs. Next, they have one pair of chelicerae is a structure which are responsible for capturing the food material. Okay, so they have one pair of chelicerae used in capturing the food material. Then next, they have one pair of pedipalps. Okay, and the pedipalps, they are also used in capturing the food for reproduction. Okay, so they are used for capturing the food and for reproduction. Okay, so these are the structures which are found in the excretion. They have malphigian tubules, coxal glands. In case of Archaenida, that is class Archaenida, we have the malphigian tubules and the coxal glands. See, in all the classes of phylum Arthropoda, the characteristics are remaining similar. Okay, but four characters can be seen as they are having different classes and they are having different examples. Okay, so as far as examples are concerned, the different characteristics will be followed. The next. For respiration, we have tracheary system. Tracheary system and book lungs. Okay, they have tracheary system and the book lungs for respiration. So when we'll discuss about the examples like the spider and the scorpion, we can see the different types of respiratory system into them. Okay, the next examples. So we'll see the examples of the class Arcanida. Okay, I hope you are getting this, because just you have to remember this characteristic feature. See what are these characters, I'll explain once again. Okay, the body of the Arcanida, okay, is been divided into cephalothorax and the abdomen. Okay, so cephalothorax is the part which consists of the head plus thorax. Head plus thorax means the head part and the thorax. Okay, in the humans we call it as a rib part. Okay, that is the thoracic region. And the upper part. Then cephalothorax have four pairs of walking legs. Okay, so they have four pairs of walking legs in the cephalum, means thoracic region basically. It is from head to the thoracic part. Then they have one pair of chelicerae. Chelicerae is the part which is used for capturing the food material. It is the one chelicerae. The next, they have one pair of pedipalps. Pedipalps is the part of capturing the food as well as using the brain part. Okay. The next, for excretion, they have Malpighian tubules and coxal glands. Okay, so excretion can be done with the help of either Malpighian tubules or the coxal glands. Okay, so both are not present in the same animal, because as far as examples are concerned, we can see the differences. The next, respiration can be performed by the tracheary system or the book lungs. Okay, so these are these few characteristic feature under class Arcanida. So let's see the examples. There are two examples that we are going to study in this class. The example is the scorpion. Okay, so see the examples. So here, example number one, that is the spider. Okay, then example number two, that is the scorpion. Let's see the certain characteristic feature of spider as well. From glands, and these glands are called spinnerets. Okay, so basically what we see in the spider, they releases the web from the body. Okay, and the part from which they are releasing the web, that is called as the, that is, that are the glands, and these glands are the spinneret glands. Okay, the spinneret glands. The next, they do not have two parts. Okay, that is the See, if we talk about the spark gauge, see, talk. Okay, the abdomen is further consisting of certain segmented parts. That is the lower part of the abdomen. So, that is the lower part of the abdominal segment. You can see there will be formation of a sting. Okay, the sting has been formed. So such a body is been seen in the scorpion. Okay, and this is referred as the. Okay, so the sting is consisting of the poison or the poisonous sting. Poisonous sting. The next, these are the segmented part. Or the abdominal segment, you can call this as abdominal segment. The next point in this, females eats males after copulation. See what happens. Females, they eat the males. Okay, after reproduction or the after sexual reproduction, that is called copulation. Okay, these are the two examples which can be seen under class Arachnida. Then we are moving to the next class, that is class Crustacea. Third class, that is the class Crustacea. Okay. Let's start the class of something. Examples, that is prawn, crabs and the tapir. Okay, so the general characteristics of the class Crustacea: body is divided. Body is divided into. Body is divided into. Around the cephalothorax. The next, they have generally 5 pairs of pairs of walking machines. See, they may, the walking legs may be variable, so generally, okay, there are actually 5 pairs of walking legs. Then next, respiration is branchial means the respiration is through the gills, okay, is through the gills, branchial, that means through gills, okay. And if we take an example of the prawn or the crab, okay, they are found in the aquatic habitat, right? So they are found in the water and they have the particular type of respiration, that is through the gills, okay. The next, excretion is by green glands. Excretion is by green glands, which are also called as antennary glands. Okay, so these are present just near to the antennas or the at the base part of the antennas, okay, in these animals, and which are responsible for excretion. Okay, so these are also named as green glands and the antennary glands. Okay, then let's see the example. Prawn. Okay, so for understanding the example prawn, we have to understand the picture. Okay, while drawing the or while writing the characteristics of the prawn, we'll draw the picture of the prawn also. So these are the some or few basic characteristic feature of class Crustacea. That is, it is divided into cephalothorax and abdomen. The next, cephalothorax is covered by a cover called carapace. This is the most important characteristic feature of the class Crustacea. Then they have generally 5 pairs of walking legs. The respiration is branchial, that is through the gills. Excretion is with the help of green glands, or which are also referred as the antennary glands, as they are found at the base of the antennas. See, in the insects we see, or in the arthropods generally we see, they have the antennas, okay, but it is absent in case of the spider, okay. So here they consist of antenna, at the base of antenna there is a presence of the antennary glands or the green gland, which are responsible for excretion. Now let's see the example. Okay, that is, first example is the prawn. Okay, so here we are going to start with the first example. Prawn. Okay, the scientific name of the prawn is Palmon or Palemon. Okay, so let's see the general characteristic feature of the prawn. The cephalothorax. The cephalothorax is extended into a pointed structure called rostrum. Okay, so cephalothorax, that is the covering, okay, or the cephalothorax, that is the head as well as thorax part, it is extended into a pointed structure called rostrum. Okay, they have one pair of eyes. The next, they have two pairs of antenna. Okay, the next, they have five pairs of walking legs. The next, and these walking legs, they arise from the thoracic cavity, which arises from thorax. Okay, which arises from the thorax. The next, abdomen has six segments. So abdominal region in case of this animal is seen as six segmented. We'll look after these points when we'll draw the structure of the prawn, so that we'll understand all these characteristic features. Okay. Now these six segments consist of an additional structure. Okay. To the abdominal segments, that structure is called pleopods. Pleopods are used for swimming. Okay, so pleopods are the structure which are attached to the six segments, abdominal six segments, and help in the swimming. Okay, as they are found in the water, so they swim. The next, sexes are separate. Okay, sexes are separate. That means they show the sexual dimorphism. Male and female are different. The next, development is, I'll write here, development is direct. Okay, development is direct. And one more characteristic feature they have, let's see the structure first of all, then we'll compare it. Okay, so if we draw the structure of the prawn, okay, so it has the body like this. This part is having a covering. Okay, this part, that is the abdominal part, or the head part is there. This is the head part. Okay, this part is having a covering that is called carapace. Okay, this part is called carapace. The next, the part which is extended from the cephalothorax, this part is the cephalothorax. Okay, that is the cephalothorax, has an extended region. Okay, and this extended region is called as the rostrum. Okay, so the extended part of the cephalothorax is called as the rostrum. Okay, so this is the rostrum. Okay, and here they have the antennas like this. Okay, here they have the antennas. Now a pair of eyes are located over here. will draw it by some other pen. So here you can see a pair of eyes are seen. That is, the bulgy eyes are there. Okay, then body. See, a pair of eyes are seen. Then two pairs of antennas are seen. Okay, so we are drawing from one side, so we can see only one pair. Okay, the next, it consists of five pairs of legs which are arising from the thoracic part. Okay, it consists of five pairs of legs. So the, as we can see, these are under arthropods, they have the jointed appendages. So the classification is also, see what it is based on, it is based on the number of appendages and the mode of excretion. So see here, number of appendages, there are five pairs. Okay, these are five pairs of the appendages that are emerging from the thoracic cavity or the thoracic region. Okay, and it the abdomen, okay, the abdominal part is having the six segments. Abdominal part is having the six segments. Two, three, four. Again, we'll draw two more segments. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six segments can be seen in the abdominal part. Okay. And you can also show this part as a abdomen. Okay, the next, every abdominal segment has pleopods. And these pleopods are used for swimming purpose. Okay, every abdominal segment has pleopods, okay, which are used for swimming purpose. Okay, these are actually small, we have drawn very large, sorry. Okay, so they are having the pleopods which are used for swimming purpose. Then at the distal part, there will be such a structure. And in between this, there will be a tail-like structure called the telson. Telson. And this flap-like structures are called as the uropods. Okay, these are called uropods. So here you can see the eyes are there. Okay, this region is the cephalothorax. It is covered by a cover called carapace. Okay, it has the thorax region. This thorax region is consisting of the legs, that is five pairs of walking leg, walking legs. Okay, abdominal segments are 6, and these 6 segments consist of the 6 segment consist of the pleopods. These are called pleopods. What is the function of pleopods? Is used for swimming purpose. Okay, the next one more characteristic feature is about the prawns. Okay, so what is that characteristic feature about the prawns? Is they show a property called autotomy. Okay, autotomy means what? See, it is an ability of any specific most probably the leg region as well as this pleopod region. Okay, they have the ability to cut them under adverse condition or during the defense mechanism. So it is a defense mechanism in case of the prawns. Okay, at the time of defense they can cut their own limbs, or they can cut their own pleopods. Okay, and which are regenerated again. So that is the defense mechanism can be seen in the case of prawns. So see the characteristics and you have to draw the diagram very carefully. Okay, if any doubt is there, you can ask me. The next we are going to move towards the another example in the class Crustacea. So I'll rub this. You can pause the video and draw the diagram. So, another example that we are going to discuss is the example number 2, that is crabs. Okay, so crabs, in crabs, the carapace is very large. Okay, and they have 4 pairs of legs. Okay, that is 4 pairs of legs, and the first pair, okay, first pair is called chelate leg. Okay, as why it is called chelate leg, as the crabs, okay, at the tip of the first pair of legs there will be presence of the claws. Okay, these claws are used for capturing any kind of prey. Okay, so here we will see the diagram as well as we can see the 4 pairs of legs. So here you can see they have the jointed legs again. So these are the first pair of legs. Which are having the claws, which are having the claws. So here also at the same, in the same way, okay. So such a structure we can see here, there will be the pair of eyes, and such a structure can be seen in case of crabs. So which consists of four pairs of leg, 1, 2, 3, 4 here, one more is there. Okay, so such a structure can be seen in case of crabs. The next, Daphnia, third example, example number 3, Daphnia. So what exactly the Daphnia is? See, Daphnia is very much important as it has a very, very good economical importance. That means it is used as pollution indicator. Okay, so this is about the class Crustacea. Three different examples we have seen: prawns, then crabs, and the Daphnia. Okay, so these are the examples under class Crustacea. Then we are going to move the next class, that is class Insecta. Okay, and few more examples we will see in the class Insecta. So the next class is the class Insecta, that is fourth class, class Insecta. So it is the largest class under phylum Arthropoda. As I told you in the very beginning, or the first point, as I have described about the phylum Arthropoda, that it consists of around 9 lakh species, of which 7,50,000 species are of only insects. So there is a huge amount of insects can be studied under phylum Arthropoda. Okay, so here we'll write the general characteristic features of the class Insecta. Insecta is largest class of this phylum. Which phylum? Phylum Arthropoda. The next, the body is divided into head, thorax, and abdomen. So they have three different parts, that is head, thorax, and the abdomen. The next, the mouth parts, okay, the mouth parts are biting and chewing type, biting and chewing type, okay, or sucking type, okay. So the mouth part can be depending, means that can be of biting and chewing type and sucking type, that depends upon the feed they get, okay. If a kind of solid feed is there, then the biting and chewing type of mouth parts will be there. If supposed to suck the any kind of liquid substance from the organisms, then it is called sucking type. In case of mosquito, they suck the blood, right? So they have the sucking type of mouth parts. So that is depend upon the feed. Okay. The next, the thorax has three pairs of walking legs. So in thoracic region we can see three pairs in the sense, how much? That will be the six legs will be there from the both the sides, that is three here and three here. Okay, so three pair of walking legs, also called hexapoda. Hexa means six and poda means legs. Okay, so six legs they have. The next, in thoracic region, wings are present. Okay, which are one to two pairs. So in case of some many insects, you can see they consist of the wings which are used for flight, taking the flight, and which can be in the one or two pairs. Okay, the next, excretion is through malphigian tubules. So most probably in case of insects, they consist of malphigian tubule, that is the excretory system, okay, used for excretion. The next, respiration is through tracheary system. Okay, so here we can see such a characteristic features in the class Insecta. So class Insecta is the largest class under phylum, okay, of the phylum Arthropoda. The body is divided into three parts, that is the head, thorax and abdomen. The mouth parts are biting and chewing type, as well as they have the sucking type of mouth part, and that depends upon the type of feed they have, okay, or type of food they are getting. Then next, the thorax has three pairs of walking legs, also called as the hexapoda, that is on the basis of number of legs, okay, or number of appendages. Then next, in thoracic region, wings are present, and which are having one or two pairs. The next, excretion is through the malphigian tubule and respiration is through tracheary system. Now let's see the examples under this class. Okay, so now we are going to see the examples, okay, examples of the Insecta, that is class Insecta. So let's see the examples. I'll write the examples over here. Okay, so cockroach. Okay, then we have the bees, which are referred as honeybees. Then mosquitoes, comma housefly, comma lepisma, which is also referred as the silverfish. Okay, the fish name is given, but it is not fish actually, it is an insect. The next we have butterflies. Okay, or the butterfly, then moth, then Xenopsilla. Xenopsilla, which are also referred as rat flea. Okay, so these are the examples under class Insecta. Now let's see few examples. Okay, we are not going to discuss all the examples, but we'll see few examples. Okay, so like we'll discuss about cockroach. Okay, we'll discuss about the cockroach one. So let's start with the first, that is the cockroach. See, before starting with the cockroach, I would like to tell you that this point of the cockroach, that is morphology, anatomy, all the structures that we are going to discuss in the next chapter, that is structural organization of animal. So, but still, to understand what kind of insect it is, we'll note down certain important points over here also. Okay, so the cockroach, we'll write the general characters. It has head, thorax, and abdomen. That means the body is divisible into three main parts, that is the head, thorax, and abdomen. The next, head has a pair of compound eyes. Okay, compound eyes in the sense they can see the mosaic type of vision. Okay, so with the eyes they can see many number of images at a time. Okay, so that is called compound eyes. And antenna. Okay, so they have a pair of compound eyes as well as the antenna. Then next, and biting. Okay, biting and chewing. Type of mouth parts. Okay, so cockroaches, basically they have the body is divided into three parts, and the head part consists of a pair of compound eyes, a pair of antenna, then biting and chewing type of mouth parts are also located in the head region itself. Okay, then next is head. From the head, basically when we look after the head of the cockroach, it is triangular, and the ventral part of the head consists of the mouth parts. Okay, anterior ventral. Okay, so at the anterior part, from the ventral side, the mouth is there. The mouth consists of chewing and biting type. Okay, the next, thorax has three pairs of legs, and two pairs of wings. So it has three pairs of legs and two pairs of wings. So thoracic region, as I told about the general classification in the class Insecta, they are called as the hexapoda. So here we can see the hexapoda nature, that is by the three pair of legs. Then excretion is through malpighian body or malpighian tubule. Okay, malpighian tubule will be there, which act as a excretory system for the in the cockroaches. Then next, respiration is through trachearia system okay so respiration is through the trachearia system. This trachearia system consists of small minute pores called spiracles. Yesterday we have discussed about it in the phylum Arthropoda general characteristics. The next, they show sexual dimorphism. What do you mean by sexual dimorphism? That means the sexes are separate, male and female can be differentiated. The next, females have ovipositor. So what is mean by ovipositor? So it is a sac like structure which is responsible for storing the eggs. Okay, so they store the eggs, or which can also be acting as a site for fertilization. So when male and female gamete, they fuses at that time, they fuses under this structure, that is ovipositor. Then next, the development is, I'll write here, development is direct. Okay, so directly it will develop into the young cockroaches, that is called nymph actually. Okay, so that is development is direct. So these are some important features of the cockroaches. Okay, many more characteristics are there that will be discussed in the next chapter, that is structural organization of animal. It is clearly given in this chapter, so we'll discuss about it in that chapter. The next example we are going to discuss is the Lepisma, which is called as the silverfish. Okay, that is Lepisma called silverfish. So the next example is the example number 2, Lepisma. Okay, about honeybees and other also we are going to study in future in biology itself. So here we will discuss some example that are not studied further. So here Lepisma, which is also named as silver fish. Okay, so this is an insect, it is not a fish basically. Okay, so it is small insect. Okay, it is small insect and wingless, it doesn't have the wings, wingless. The next, it is found in old books or old cloths. Okay, so whenever we keep the books or the cloths under a shelf, okay, or in a cupboard, at that time, after a long period of time, there will be deposition of the insects, and those insects are nothing but the silverfish, or they are also referred as the Lepisma. Okay, and the structure, it is spindle like. Okay, so such a structure can be seen. They will be having antennas, eyes. Okay, so such a structure can be seen, that is called the Lepisma. Then the third example is butterflies. And moth. butterflies and moth. So see, butterflies and moth, both are basically similar in structure, but butterflies are larger than the moths. And you know, butterflies, they are what we say, they are visible during daytime, okay, and moths, they are visible most probably during the night time. So during night time, around the tubes or the bulb, electric bulb, we see the certain insects, they are moving, and these insects are nothing but the moth, okay, and they have generally brown or the dark colored structure, okay, while butterflies, they have the light colored wings, okay, or they are having different colors which are lighter. So here we'll write, they have two pairs of legs and two pairs of wings. Okay, they have two pairs of legs and two pairs of wings. The basic difference between the butterfly and the moth is, okay, butterflies are active during daytime. Okay, butterflies are active during daytime, whereas moths are active during night time. Okay, so you might be seeing many insects, most especially in the rainy season, okay, around the bulb or electric bulb or the tube in your houses, small insects like butterfly like insects are moving, and these insects are nothing but the moth. Okay, the next, larva of butterfly is called caterpillar. Okay, is called caterpillar, and this and the development is indirect. Okay, so development in case of butterflies as well as moth is indirect. Okay, that is, it will undergo the larval stage. Larva will be formed, from larva pupa will be formed, and from the pupa adult stage will be there. So through different stages it will develop, okay, into an adult organism. The next, okay, so these are the few examples under class Insecta. Okay, now next we are going to move to the next classes. Okay, that is, this was the fourth, and next we are going to move towards the few more classes, that is class Chilopoda, okay, and class Diplopoda. We will discuss here about these two different classes, that is class Chilopoda and class Diplopoda. That is the fifth class, class Chilopoda, and sixth class, that is class Diplopoda. See, both of these classes having few similar characteristic features. Okay, if you talk about the structural appearance, they are quite similar in their structure. We'll discuss about them. Okay, so example under class Chilopoda is सेंटीपीड, सेंटीपीड, ओके। एंड इन केस ऑफ डिप्लोपोडा द एग्जांपल विल बी मिलीपीड, ओके। नाउ बोथ ऑफ दिस क्लासेस आर वर्म लाइक, ओके। द ऑर्गेनिज्म व्हिच आर फाउंड इन दिस आर वर्म लाइक। देन नेक्स्ट लेट्स सी द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर ऑफ द चिलोपोडा फर्स्ट, ओके। दीज आर और इट इज कार्निवोर, इट इज कार्निवोर। नॉर्मली नॉक्ट्यूनल, ओके। एंड फास्ट मूविंग, सो दे बेसिकली मूव वेरी फास्ट। देन नेक्स्ट बॉडी इज डिवाइडेड इंटू, बॉडी इज डिवाइडेड इंटू हेड एंड ट्रंक, ओके। बॉडी इज डिवाइडेड इंटू हेड एंड ट्रंक। नेक्स्ट दे हैव पेयर ऑफ कंपाउंड आईज, कंपाउंड आईज एंड अ पेयर ऑफ एंटीने, ओके, पेयर ऑफ एंटीने। द नेक्स्ट द बॉडी इज सेगमेंटेड बेसिकली, ओके। सो इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ मेनी सेगमेंट्स इन द थोरैसिक एज वेल एज इन द एब्डोमिनल पार्ट। सो द एवरी सेगमेंट हैज paired jointed appendages, okay. So these are the characteristic feature of the centipede, okay. If you look at the structure, okay, the body is quite flat or cylindrical, you can see. This is the anterior part and consists of a pair of compound eyes, okay. Here a pair of compound eyes is there and consists of a pair of antennae, right. Then next, from the first segment itself, okay, the body is like this of centipede. In Marathi it is called gom, okay. In different regions we can have their particular local names, okay. So according to my Marathi it is called gom, okay. Then consists of a pair of legs in each segment, like this, and they have the particular structures or the stinging cells at the end of that stinging cells, they have the claws, okay. They have the claws, so these are the claws, and such a structure can be seen in case of centipede. The next, and these claws are basically poisonous, poisonous claws, okay. Now next, in case of millipede, okay, in contrast to carnivore, they are herbivores, okay. They are herbivores. The next, they are slow moving, slow moving animals. Okay, head or the body is divided into head, thorax and abdomen. Okay, body is divided into head, thorax and abdomen. The next, they have a pair of compound eyes and segments. Okay, segmented legs. Okay, the next, the thoracic cavity or the thoracic segment has one pair of legs. Okay, one pair of legs, that is three thoracic, means at first three thoracic segments. Okay, so if we look after the body, it is quite similar to the body of the centipede. Okay, it is also having an anterior mouth. Okay, and having a compound eyes with antennae. Okay, now is they are also having the antennae. And here, as the body starts, here it has the three segments. These three segments are called thoracic segments. Okay, and this thoracic segment are the first three segments, which consist of a pair of legs. Okay, a pair of legs are seen. But throughout the body, entire body, that is from the abdominal region, everywhere they have the two pairs of legs. Okay, so here two pairs of legs will be there like this. So around in both the animals we can see 40 to 70 segments are seen. Okay, 40 to 70 segments are seen in case of both of these animals. Okay, so as and these animals, okay, here they don't have the poisonous claws. So these are the two different classes, that is class Chilopoda and class Diplopoda. Two more common points are there. So what are those common points between this? See, they show respiration. Okay, so respiration in case of both. Respiration is by tracheary system. Which is a common function in both, that is in the centipede as well as in the millipede. The next example, that is in both, excretion is by malpighian tubule or malpighian tubule. So these are the few characteristic features of the different classes under phylum Arthropoda. One more class is there, okay, that we'll be discussing in the next class when we'll discuss about the phylum Mollusca. Okay, till then, thank you.